Hi, and welcome to Across the Desk. This week, we're going to talk about our wonderful governor, Mr. Stitt, who's been throwing fits the last couple of weeks, getting together with his new attorney general, putting people on boards, going after those who oppose him, and just really power grabbing like you wouldn't believe. That's this week on Across the Desk. So I don't know how many shows you've watched of Across the Desk, but we've done a few episodes of Stitt, and the last one we did was about the Stitt Fit, where he went after the tribe down in south over there by Norman because of the road they want to put in, and they're going to pay for most of it, but he decided we're going to put that on hold because, you know, McGirt, and he lost his butt, $2 million fiasco. So here we go. Probably another $2 million fiasco after $2 million fiasco coming up, because one, he just keeps losing everything he's doing. All these overreaches and oversteps, which is kind of funny. He wants to talk about how Biden's overreaching and overstepping when that's exactly what Stitt does at every time. But anyway, the other interesting thing about that is here he is power grabbing, overreaching. And then he really desperately wants you to go, no, don't look at me. Look at Biden overreaching. Not me. No, we want to kind of look at you overreaching. That's what this is about. So here we go. He got slammed in court. They already said, one, here's one ruling against him, unemployment insurance. Took away the $300 stipend that everybody was getting on the unemployment insurance increase. Took it away unilaterally, saying, it just keeps people at home, doesn't incentivize them to work. Of course, he's just pulling this out of his butt. He doesn't have any stats to prove anything he says, just bulleted talking points from some think tank or the NRCC like everybody else pulls out. So that's what we have here with our governor, Kevin Stitt. So he tries to take away the health, or not health, but unemployment insurance of Oklahomans 3 months early, get slammed for it, and now they say, hey man, you gotta pay this all back. You gotta start putting this in place and you need to re-implement this stuff. Because what you did was overstepped your boundaries. You didn't have the authority to do it. You shouldn't have done it. This is an overreach of your office because, you know, you're an authoritarian. And that's just how Stitt rolls. And if things don't go the way Stitt wants, well, he goes after people. He goes after them. And in ways like you wouldn't believe. Wow, a government official would go after somebody. Using the power and the force of big government to go after people. That's what Stitt does. And he's done it on more than one occasion. And I imagine we'll probably see something happen with the overreach that he was called on when it comes to unemployment insurance. I'm expecting somewhere along the line he's going to go after judges because those are the ones who tell him, hey man, this doesn't follow any of state constitution, federal constitution, can't do this. So I imagine he'll find a way to get back at those people. But really, the biggest issue that's been coming up in the last couple of weeks, especially this late, last week and the week before, is the mask mandates in schools. So, one, you got all these schools who want to put in these mask mandates locally, which is kind of a weird deal. Here we go again. Republicans, right? Conservatives, liking to dish it. We love that small government control, you know, keep it local, 10th Amendment. But as soon as somebody local does something a conservative doesn't like, well, we're going to use our power of big government that we're in control of to force your municipality, your school district to comply with what we feel here at the state. And that's what they're doing. And as you see, that's exactly what they're doing. Because one of the things is this Senate Bill 658. That's what this is all about. Senate Bill popped up. And here's a list of guys right here and gals, mostly guys, and they're no strangers to very far right ring extremism and controversies. These guys here are the ones who came up with Senate Bill 658. Now, a lot of these names on here are rural. They live out in the country. They're not in the city. We're like Oklahoma City, Tulsa, where they want to put in mask mandates. So this is the rural areas trying to tell city people how they're going to come in and tell us how we're going to control our stuff locally. And that's exactly what we have here. Because all these representatives, they don't represent the people that want to put in these mask mandates. They really don't. And when it comes down to it, really, two-thirds of Oklahoma parents agree that we need to have mask mandates for unvaccinated children who want to go to school. We need to do that because kids under 12 can't get vaccinated. They're unvaccinated and they're at risk. They're actually been the highest group of people that have been going to the hospital lately. Most of the schools back in session, and we have, you know, a governor that wants to pander to the base who are anti-maskers and anti-vaxxers. And that's exactly what he's doing. He's pandering to those people because they're the ones who wants and he thinks that's where his votes are. That's where his voter base is. And those are the people that he's really pandering to. So that's what we have here in this big machination of all this stuff. It's a big political ploy because, yeah, we want to stop mask mandates from local at the local level. These guys here hate local control. They love big government. Olson, hey, you know, Representative Olson did a show a couple seasons ago about how he loves big government, and this isn't the only time. He's got other bills he's put out that love on the big conservative government. He does it. He does it a lot. Another thing here, we got the other lawsuits that are happening are the feds are suing, of course, Biden administration. They're going to go after him. Parents have been suing the governor over this. At least two school districts, if not more, are suing him over this, not allowing local level mask mandates because this is a big overreach of state governor power. That's what it is. And that's what Stitt's all about. He's all about the power, how much he can consolidate, how big of an authoritarian he can be, and how big of an autocracy we can create Oklahoma. That's exactly what he is. That's exactly where he is, and that's exactly what he's about. And you can see it right here. And he's got this attorney general yes man now. Because, you know, the other guy who was really horrible. I mean, the guy was so corrupt, he quit. So now, Stitt was able to put in his yes man, who's not qualified to be an attorney general. He's not. But hey, you know what? Stitt's not all about qualifications, because here we go. He also, what did he do? Here we go. In another Stitt fit, switching the subject, we're going to talk about the board of the medical board, where he got rid of two people and put on two new people. Well, one, the two people he got rid of, they're licensed doctors. The two new people he put on, they're not. As a matter of fact, one of them, he was there as PPP czar here in Oklahoma. If you know the guy who was last year supposed to get all the stuff together for masks and everything else for everybody, put him in charge of that, didn't know anything about medical supply business because the guy was in oil and gas his whole life. Guy's in oil and gas his whole life. Now he sits on a board making medical decisions. Think about that. Why is he on that board when he's not qualified? Because he's a yes man. He's got a lot of money. Let's put it that way. That's how he got on there. Not because he's qualified. So that's what we got there with why he got rid of those two people. Now, why did he get rid of those people? Well, you know what? They're against his privatization scheme, right? Because we passed, through initiative petition, we passed Medicaid expansion. And we want the Oklahoma government to control it. It's the way it is in law. Well, Stitt doesn't like that. He's got buddies, you see, that want that money. It's a lot of money. And so he's got buddies who want that money. And, well, you know, he got really screwed out of it. Tried to get everything going, tried to get this whole thing going to get it out of the state, send our money out of state, get some private companies to handle our Medicaid, and got sued. What happened? Well, big fiasco again. He got lost. He lost the case, lost it again. Well, I mean, how many times is this guy going to lose stuff? Another $2 million fiasco. So here we go, loses. So what do you got to do? Well, now you got to, you can't privatize the Medicaid. You're gonna have to run it in state. So what does he do? He tries to, after all this, get this, do back channel, backdoor deals with the board to privatize some of this so he can placate his buddies he promised them the money to, you see, because that's how Stitt rolls. So he's doing that. And that's why, so whenever this all happened, he tried to do it on a holiday weekend where he thought nobody would pay attention, and bam, got nailed for it. Hey man, we're putting two people on this board that aren't even qualified to sit here. What are you doing? Well, we know what he's doing. I just explained it. So that's what you got. And then let's go. So now let's go back. Let's go back to this local control thing. You see, because there's a they want to repeal this 658. There's a deal called the Safer at School Act, and they're wanting to move that along. Of course, we'll see what happens because the courts have had a lot to say about this mask mandate and shutting it down, and even the state superintendent coming out saying, you know, I don't think it's constitutional that the governor can do a mask mandate on school boards. It's we don't think it's constitutional, and a lot of people don't. And I don't think it's going to fly. There may not be anything that needs to be done. We'll see what happens with that. My big concern is with all of this, the governor, you know, he's not one to not like people that aren't yes men. He likes to go after people that he can't win against, like the Native American tribes or school districts. And this makes total sense, you know, why they don't want a mask mandate in schools, right? Because one, they hate public education and they don't like teachers. Because conservatives feel teachers are liberals. They're indoctrinating all our kids to be liberals. So they hate them anyway. So one, if we don't have mask mandates and they're not vaccinated, then, you know, if they die off, we can kill teachers off that way. And I guarantee you, see in the Facebook posts that I read, there are conservatives out there who feel exactly that way. And that they're okay with no mask mandates and no vaccine mandates and sending all the kids to school to get all in the teachers and everything else because they hate public schools. They hate teachers. That's how conservatives roll. Because here's how you can tell. This mask mandate thing and everything else, one of the big reasons why it got thrown out, it's unconstitutional because it doesn't offer equal protection under the law. Because private schools and charters, they don't have to comply with any of this. This only applies to public. Public schools can institute a mask mandate. But private and charters can, and they do, and are. So that tells you right there. This is a big... We hate on public education. It always is with them. And that's exactly what we have here. And that's what you're seeing with this anti-mask mandate and the AG saying, I'm going to sue these schools. What a buffoon. The guy's a moron. And the guy's not even qualified to be our AG. He's going to go after school districts. He's going to sue school districts. He's going to sue parents. That's where our AG is. Such a yes man to the governor that he can't get his tongue out of his butt. And that's what we have with an attorney general right now in Oklahoma. I guess we ought to feel okay that the guy's not qualified because really there's a lot less damage he could do than Mike Hunter did. And I feel like maybe that's where we're at. I mean, and that's sad, isn't it? Where you're like, wow, at least it's not Mike Hunter. You know? But still, this guy is just a yes man, doesn't know what he's doing, bumbling around just like our governor's bumbling around, wasting our taxpayer money on frivolous lawsuits that they're never going to win. But the AG knows that. He's just doing it to make Stitt happy, I guess. And that's where we're at with what the AG's doing with the governor and the mask mandates and any kind of vaccine or anything else. Because the other thing was they talked about vaccine mandates. Well, this is where we're off with this. And the AG's pulled this off the table to sue private companies who want to mandate vaccinations because the governor's against that. While other Republicans, the big government Republicans on this list, they're all for telling private companies what to do if it goes against their conservative principles. Very much into big government telling private companies what to do, everyone on this list. They are. Well, that's our show for this week. Hope you enjoyed us talking about the Stitt Fit and the local on his unemployment insurance fiasco, the mask mandate fiasco, and the medical board removal fiasco that he's all going through right now because he's throwing fits and he's not getting his way and people are saying, hey, you're being an authoritarian and unconstitutionally power grabbing and we're taking it back. Oh, wait, before I go, I want to talk about something else. The Democrats just this week are putting together a plan to take back some of that power because of what Stitt is doing and we're watching it right here on live. So they're getting ready to come out with something. Guy came out, just made a press conference this week about, hey, you know what? We're going to grab some of this power that Stitt has claimed that he shouldn't have. Yep, so there you go. We'll see you next week.